Police in New York descended in the dead of night to clear away the Wall Street protesters. They say they made around 200 arrests at what's been called the ground zero of the anti-capitalist protest movement. The New York mayor, Michael Bloomberg, accused the demonstrators of making life intolerable for people by putting their health and safety at risk. Our foreign affairs correspondent, Jonathan Rugman, has this.
This was the moment when police moved in just after 1 o'clock in the morning. The protesters' camp in Lower Manhattan was under siege.
The erection of tents and structures and the storage of personal belongings are prohibited in Zuccotti Park.
About 100 of those occupying Zuccotti Park stayed put, locking their arms together and mounting makeshift barricades until the police ejected them by force.
Can somebody get some justice out here? Can I get justice?
They're taking the park. They're surrounding the park in riot gear. They're taking it and they're trying to block up every street right now. They're lining up to surround us.
Around 200 people were arrested as protesters moved across Lower Manhattan and were joined by supporters who'd heard the news.
Our streets! Our streets!
But police frequently moved them on. While their campsite, the epicenter of protests across America for 2 months now, was cleared of rubbish and scrubbed clean. Defying the early hours outcry, New York's mayor claimed the eviction was his decision, that the camp was a health and fire hazard, which broke the park owner's no sleeping rule.
There is no ambiguity in the law here. The First Amendment protects speech. It does not protect the use of tents and sleeping bags to take over a public space.
Just a few blocks from Zuccotti Park, protesters sprawled across another square, sleeping off the night's events. Though they insisted this setback in their fight against the financial system would only galvanize their movement.
The fact that this movement ignited a national, international movement shows you there's such a hunger and a need and a desire, a timeliness, that this is wanted, you know? So we're going to continue. We just have to formulate a strategy of how we're going to do that.
I personally feel we should go back to the park and take it over.
And some are already trying to do just that. This afternoon, police were keeping protesters at the edge of Zuccotti Park. Some local residents said they were relieved the campsite had been dismantled, though the protesters have obtained a court order from a judge, which throws the park's new rules into doubt.